The reason Panasonic is so unpopular amongst today's youths is because when they were children, they went to a bake sale, and when Kenan Thompson brought the apple pie, everyone was like in love. It's like, I have classic apple pie, thank you. And then Sony Witherspoon brings muffins, chocolate chip muffins, and like, that might even be better than the apple pie. Panasonic brought baked lizards, and like, they were good. If you got over the mental hurdle, you could enjoy a meal, but it's lizard feet. That's why they bring shame to your family. But that doesn't mean stores won't stock them forever. We have some tips for you, Panty Boy.
All I want is the perfect camera. All I want is the perfect camera.
All right, I'm testing out Olympus's 1080p. Because I am sick of my computer crying at me every time I try to edit a 4K file. It could look good enough, and if it doesn't, I do have a magnifying glass that I will use later in the show. So I asked Camera Canada if they had a Panasonic GH6 in stock, and I was thinking maybe one of those Leica lenses, see what they have, and they're like, yeah, we don't really stock much Panasonic zero full frame stuff. And he could get me a GH6, but it's not like lining their shelves like my white cabinets over there. So I thought that was weird, a camera store not stocking Panasonic cameras. And then Aiden Camera, I go over there in person and I'm like, there's nothing of they had one Panasonic S1 and they're like hoping to give it away. They're not ordering anything new, like none of the full frame stuff. They have no Micro Four Thirds anything. I'm like, what's going on here? And that reminded me of back in Thailand when I went into the store, they had no Panasonic gear. I was like, do you have Panasonic? I don't have the clip on me, but y'all have seen it. The fans of the show, you know. She was like, Panasonic? Oh no, sorry. We don't know, Cup Kun Krap. They don't have it. So that has me thinking, why is this? Like, there's six major camera companies, Canon, Panasonic, Sony, Fuji, Olympus, Nikon. There's Blackmagic and Red and all those, but those aren't real. GoPro, DJI, get real with yourself. When you look at the specs, like of a Panasonic camera, for the price, they're leading, if not trailing, the industry. They're interesting. Like the best video assist tools, waveforms, custom buttons that actually work perfectly, instant switch. Great specs, like sharp 4K, like the codecs are brilliant. You have to think, like, why? Why these stores aren't stocking their items? Why is this? They're one of the major six brands. Why? Distract them with a magnifying glass show. Big foreheads are back. Now, I'll be honest with you, I prefer almost every other camera system to Panasonic, and that could be one of the reasons why nobody stocks them, but I do remember comparing this Olympus versus the G9, and I did the slow-mo, and I was blown away by how much better their slow-mo was. 180 frames versus 120 in here, but just the quality of the image, like this was just over-sharpened gunk, and that was like, wow. Beautiful cinema quality. Panty Boy footage is sharp. They got some dynamic range. You put that little dynamic range boost mode on. Even the G85 had that eye dynamic mode or something. Once I found that, I was like, could you beat this thing? You couldn't. So I came up with two reasons why I think Panasonic is being left out of our new world. The first is the obvious one, the autofocus. People are just sick of it. We've had good autofocus for a long time. I think Canon 70D came out 2013. Dual pixel autofocus, like it was finally like, wow. And then Sony probably did it, maybe before that, I don't know. What was Sony's first phase detect camera? I wish I knew. I should have researched that. I turned my laptop off because it was too loud. Distract them from your lazy mindset with a new magnifying glass. Oh, that focus is much better. So, the autofocus, like Panasonic is the last company of the six. Even the ones, the fringe companies like RED are doing phase detect now. That's beautiful. My buddy said he just watched a Panasonic interview and they said, "We're starting to research phase detect autofocus for our new cameras." I'm like, "What do you mean you're starting to research?" Canon started to research back in like 2006 to make the 2013 Canon 70D. What are you doing? Well, like, which camera is this? Like, which generation? The GH9? Is that what we're waiting for? You're just starting? Like, you didn't hear the complaints for the last 7 years? You're a GH5, GH4. Pretty good. It just can't autofocus. Everybody has been yelling at you for that, and they're just so slow to do it. I'll be honest with you, when Flat Earth Santa gave me the Panasonic S1, and it was beautiful, beautiful image, I loved it. Outside with that Viltrox 20mm lens, I was like, I couldn't bring myself to invest in lenses knowing that the autofocus was that shit. I was like, I can't do that. I'm sorry. Panasonic has so much going for them. It's ridiculous. Like, just they're the best. Just using the camera feels so good. They have a Leica partnership in the mic. I swear to. That's the friend, the so-called friend who told me about the Panasonic interview interrupting my video. Imagine, like, Leica glass on your camera. You can't imagine it. It's too beautiful to be imagined. Sony's lucky with their Zeiss partnership. Panasonic has everything, but nobody cares because they can't autofocus. And the second reason, I didn't write it down. Distract them with a dual magnification show. Oh. What I've noticed, I should have wrote it down. I remember it now. I think it's because Panasonic as a company is too branched out. They're making microwaves, hair dryers, batteries, it's just weird shit, freezers. Microwaves. I already said that one. What are you doing? No one trusts you. You just make a bunch of junk. A lot of their microwaves get bad reviews. After 2 years max, they just stop. I don't like those odds. How are you gonna make a biscuit? You couldn't. But Sony is also the same. They do a bunch of electronics, the PlayStation, Sony Walkmans back in the day, radios, batteries as well. Stuff. So they're making it work. Panty boy, why can't you? I don't think I would want a Panasonic anything in my house. I'd rather a Toshiba convection oven slash microwave. I don't trust you, Panasonic. You won't even focus the heat on my food properly. It'll be pulsing and ain't gonna heat evenly. I know your plan. It's kind of sad though, because Panty boy will always have a special place in my heart. Because the G85 was my first like real professional camera, and I was like, this is cool, and it was so cheap. Once you get a nice little lens on there, a little Leica 15mm 1.7, you have the lightest, most stable vlog setup ever for pretty cheap. Leica 3D Pop, you just had to forego your autofocus delights, and if you could have the discipline to manually focus. The winner was you. So, in my opinion, if Panasonic wants to stave off near bankruptcy, which is impending and immediate, I have a tip. Give me something like the GH5S sensor with the large pixels. You're like confronting full frame, like same sized pixels as a high megapixel full frame. So, like maybe as good dynamic range. I'm just saying, low light performance could be up there. So you do something like that with your dynamic range boost that works in all modes, 4K 120p especially, full HD, 480 frames, you're upping that in a firmware. you could do something. You get the good autofocus, face detect, just, you don't have to go crazy with time of flight and LiDAR shit, new stuff. Just phase detect that works and it's reliable. You have this nice new sensor now. You're video centric. Was there one? Improved white balance technology and color science. I'm just saying. I'm a fan of this Olympus shot. I wasn't even at max brightness. That's a bitch. ISO 400. That's probably noisy as hell. So, I think they have hope. I don't understand it. Why are camera stores just giving up on Panasonic? There's something behind the scenes. They're also kind of mean, I think. The Panasonic reps and people. They do weird things like rip you off, send a rebate. Oh, you have to wait 4 months. 4 to 9 months after your purchase. And then we'll rebate you. And then you forget. And then they're like, oh, sorry, you missed your window. I know it was a short one. But you didn't jump out and cut your jugular with broken glass like you should have. Panasonic, they're mean people. And I don't think they stand by their product. Their warranties are a lie. I have no basis for any of these judgments, but something's off with that whole company. Maybe you know. You tell me. Something, but stores don't want to sell them and people feel shame buying them. I feel it. There's a shame. Something about it. Like you own a Panasonic S5 with a 50mm 1.4 and you're like, it's good. It's just, I hope nobody asked me to autofocus. It could do it. There's a shame. And I don't need that. I have enough of it in my life. I don't need a camera equipment to enhance my shame. Speaking of shame, this Pentax lens cap. Wow, that took a while. The A is coming off. Thanks for nothing, Pentax. I was going to buy the K1 with a nice 3D pop lens, but no longer, because I know it'll fall apart in my hands. So why do you think Panasonic sucks so badly, and why are camera stores refusing to sell them? Even Amazon. You couldn't find a Panasonic on Amazon right now if you tried. Click my link for it and you'll see it. I tricked you into shopping for toilet paper and I get a cut? Calm down. I know it's just 40 cents. That is exciting. That is a good time. So I'm going to leave. Thank you for watching. Tell me stuff down below after you buy a Camera Conspiracies t-shirt.